This is the Hornberg special. As close to traditional as I get. I'm going to do a couple things differently than Frank did it. Starting with, I'm going to use pearl tinsel for an underbody. Frank just used silver. But I don't have any silver. Pearl catches fish. And, who knows? Who knows what he would have done? But anyway, so here's some pearl tinsel. Frank Hornberg was a game warden, actually Portage County's first game warden, 1920. And while he was a warden there, he came up with this fly, which he dubbed the Hornberg Special. Now, it is used, was traditionally used in the Midwest as a dry fly, and they say it was used as a caddis, but that is back when they called hexes night caddis. So I am suspicious that it was never actually used as a caddis, but that it was used as a hex, as it was tied in sizes, like 4 up to 10. You have a hard time finding caddises in central Wisconsin tied from a 4 to a 10. So here, Frank used a little bit of a yellow rooster hackle, neck hackle, but I don't have any. And one of the other traditional quote-unquote ways to tie this pattern is with bucktail. So we're going to use a little bit of a white-tail deer bucktail here. It was dyed yellow. Cinch that down right there. 1, 2. And cut these off. And neaten that up a little bit. So already we're two paces off traditional. Well, I think in the end we'll come around to what looks like a pretty traditional fly. You can take a couple barred Frank feathers, the original Frank's original recipe calls for mallard. That's what we have here. Go ahead and cut the excess off, and then want that to go toward the hook shank. On both sides. Now, criminy. Next, Frank used jungle cock. So, because I don't have any, because that shit is expensive, I use a little bit of barred wood duck. Tie in some eyes here. And, I can't speak for Frank, but I gotta think that barred wood duck would probably have been an acceptable substitute for someone who was a game warden in Portage County. Because I'd be surprised if Frank didn't use it himself on occasion. Also use like golden pheasant tippet or anything you can make a little eye out of. Golden pheasant tippet's kind of nice because it gives you a little flash of color there too, but looks a little less traditional. Now, tidy this up a bit. Then you take a couple pieces of, I use a whiting rooster hackle. Of course, he probably didn't use whiting, but he did use a dry fly hackle. Tie them in here. We prep these feathers. Now, at this point, I'm put just a dab of super glue on there, because traditionally when my hornbergs come apart, what happens is that hackle comes unraveled. So this adds a good bit of durability to an otherwise not quite so durable fly. So make sure you sweep those hackles back. Four or five spins around there is usually plenty. And just tie her off. So, you pretty much have it. Frank Hornberg special. Named the man who tied it. First, a dry fly imitation. Central Wisconsin sand streams for caddis or hex. And originated in the 1920s.